Hey everyone, and welcome to my video or tutorial to show you a little bit about the design tool in Disney's Dreamlight Valley. I have been playing the game normally, as most people have, unlocking all the characters, playing around with the valley a little bit. And when I got to level 40, maxed out everything, I kind of discovered the design tool. I'd been messing around with it on day one a little bit, but I got, well, this particular skirt and the backpack that goes along with it, which is here, which my daughter, 3 years old, absolutely adored, along with the ever famous ice cream crocodile, which can be the only companion I'm allowed to use. And I didn't have anything to match with it. So to do that, I created this vest. And that kind of got the creative juices flowing. So I made the matching mini ears. And then the very next thing I ended up doing is moving on to dresses. Namely, another Vanellope Sugar Rush one. And well, from there on out, I just started to mess around more and more with the design tool. And in my opinion, it is the only real way to, well, get to know the tool, I guess. To learn what it can do, see the designs that you like, which things you like to play around with, and well, get creative. I've had a lot of people saying that they don't know how to create some of the things that I have here. Like this dress, for instance. And that they would want to be creating things like that. And they have been asking me for tutorials after I've been posting on a Facebook group. And I don't have a lot of time because, like I said, I have a three-year-old, I have a husband, and a few hours every day to play a little bit, in which I am usually now designing dresses. But since there have been so many people asking, and I know that the tool itself can be a little bit daunting in the beginning, I felt it, well, would be kind to make a tutorial. So just to showcase some of the things that I've made for those that are not in the Facebook group. Some of the earlier dresses that I made are these. Belle's dress, which will be for my new princess lineup as well. An up dress. I made a mini dress since her 10 friendship dress is not in yet. So, you know, we have something. And again, my daughter needed a mini dress. And anything, you know, pink. So here, I'll showcase them a little bit better at the end. Some of my villain dresses that I've recently made for the villain lineup. If you want to check them all out with the proper screens that I've made, then feel free to check out the Facebook groups in which I've posted them. And again, at the end of the video, I'll showcase the dresses again with some proper daylight, I'm hoping, since, again, I only have time in the evening. But one of the dresses that got a lot of attention was this Lion King dress. People seem to really love this dress, and unlike some of the other dresses, it is actually fairly simple to make. So I thought it'd be ideal for a tutorial, right? I mean, I have another Lion King dress here, which was next to the Scar one, a nightmare to make. People assume that these silhouettes of Scar and Simba or Mufasa or Pride Rock here, that is actually one of the motifs that you get in the game. But it isn't. It is made out of shapes all by itself. As you can see, like, Pride Rock is just bits and pieces here. A lot of bits and pieces. And even the silhouette itself is just a whole lot of... I'm not really showcasing it very well at the moment. But you can see, it's just a lot of shapes. Had to imagine the shape, basically, and make it from there. See? The Scar one is the same, and so is the dragon on the Maleficent dress. Don't want to save it like a mess, so there you go. This dragon is also custom-made. And, well, Scar's silhouette, the same as Mufasa's silhouette. But first, we will be dealing with the basics. I'll do this video, well, this was the introduction then. I'll give you the basics of the design tool, what all the advanced options do or what they can do, some tips and tricks of what people have been asking about, things that they'd like to know and that have been very recurring questions. And then after that, with having covered all that, we'll move back to Distress and try to replicate it with the very last slot that I have before I'm going to have to start deleting, probably the ears and the Jafar turban. So, going to pause the recording here and continue onwards afterwards. And we're back in the afterwards. In the 5 minutes it took me to actually check if the recording was working properly and the mic was connected and all that, it has actually gotten dark, so I will not be continuing here, my favorite place to make my screenshots, but we'll be moving on to my house. Another great place to showcase things is Moana's Realm. There is a permanent sunset there, but I do find that when designing dresses, it is a little... Well, the sunset causes essentially a filter, and it skews the colors a little bit. So I like designing my dresses here in my home, where I feel that the lighting is kind of nice. So, we're going to be showing the very basics of the design tool. So, first things first, to get to the design tool, one opens the inventory, or use the shortcut straight for the wardrobe. And over here, you can click Customize. Now, you will get layers here. You get 32 design slots to make your outfits with. I have one left, which is the one that we shall be using right now. And once you open it, you can see all the base templates that you get to work with. Hopefully in the future, we'll get some more, like pants, skirts, stuff like that. But for now, the two shapes that I like working with are the long-sleeved gown and the sweetheart strapless gown, which is the one that this Lion King dress is at. I've made a few mini ears, but as I said, I'm running out of design slots, so the first thing that gets deleted are those. But let's move on to the basics. So you click the one you want to make, you click Create, and there we go. You get 50 layers. So I prefer using the strapless gown if you make really intricate, detailed designs, because you run out of 50 layers really quick. Like, you think you have a lot, but it just runs out just like that, especially when you want to make, like I said, those intricate designs. Here, down here, is where you set the base color of the dress. Now, a little tip and trick for this is that the base color of the dress is actually slightly different from the exact same color on the palette that you can use on shapes. Like, I picked the light pink one here. And if I then place a square on my dress, and I will... Here you can pick the color for the motif that you're using. Not all motifs have this option. Just keep that in mind. Pick the exact same color, you can see that it is actually different. For some of them, the color difference is slightly less, for some of them a bit more. But if you want to make a dress in a certain color scheme, it gives you another color, essentially, to work with. So, the other options here in the base. This is just upsizing and downsizing. And this is rotating. Now, where the money is really at is in the advanced options. Let's first make this... Let's grab a different motif. Character. Let's grab Ariel, because why not? Again, that's where your color change, and we make her white. This option will mirror the motif that you currently have selected. So what it does is put Ariel in a mirrored position. This option duplicates the motif and mirrors it, and tries to mirror it on the dress itself. So if I press it, this is what will happen. Briefly, while this is enabled, you can move both at the same time. So you can try to really make them come together, like this, like this, like this. Just however you think is going to be nice. Keep in mind, it doesn't always work, especially with flourishes. It tends to put the copied flourish completely crooked. It isn't, in fact, because once you place it, it will actually create a copy, as you can see here on the left. That's the copied one that I just got. Now, when it's crooked and not mirrored properly, once you place it, it actually will be. It's just at that time you can't move them together. But I tend to like moving them separately anyway. And if I'm not happy with the position, I just delete, which is just pressing the cross, and remake it. So you can see that this duplicate area will have this option enabled because it is mirrored to the original motif. So that is the first two options. This third option, the scissors, actually create a cutout of the motif that you have. Just show this extra little color pink again. We'll place that under Arial. On the PC, just once you have that, it doesn't show this circle anymore, so you click it off. Off, I say. Then you can click and hold to drag the layers to a different position. It took me a really long while to find that out. I did it once by accident, and then it took me a good 15 minutes of trying to replicate it until I found out how. So right now we have Arial placed on top of the set square. Now if I press these scissors, it will actually cut it out of the layer below it and make it the exact same color as the base dress. Now, what it does is actually just color it the color of the base dress. It doesn't actually create a cutout, because let's say I take this, which is one of those motifs that you can't change color, as you can see, and I would place it below all these layers. If that Arial is a true cutout, that means that you would see the cactus beneath it now. Think layers of paper. It isn't. So unfortunately, that is the case. But you can still use this to, well, there's a tip and trick to that as well, which I'll get to. But you can create this to get the color back. Like I said before, you can create that extra little nuance of color and make sure that it matches the base color of the dress. Because there's nothing to match the base color of the dress besides this tool right now, since this square makes it a different shade of pink. Bye-bye square. Then this option will pattern the motif all across your dress. It will upsize it. It will turn this option on, which is the wrapping. I call it a wrapping feature, this globe, which causes the motif to nicely wrap around the dress all the way to the back. There's a seam in the middle of the dress here, which will discover can be a little bit annoying when designing, but you'll just have to work around it. Now, if I put this on, you can make them smaller, because this option also allows you to make things much bigger. But what it will do, much like with a normal layer, which we'll get to shortly, is cause some weird stretching on the side. Any roundings, for that matter. You can see it up here as well. And here it'll smudge them a little bit. So, yeah, I don't. For most of my designs, about 80% of all my layers will be with this last option. And I don't particularly like the pattern dress myself. I've made one dress with it, and that's the flower dress, just to see what I could do with the tool. But it places things in such a predictable manner that it's just too obvious, I find, that you're using the pattern tool. I mean, you can use it creatively by layering multiple repeated motifs, but yeah, I don't really use it. Right, so on to this last option. 80% of my dresses will have this, because one, it allows you to go much bigger than without it, because this is the max size without it, and this is the max size with it. And next to that, if I don't have this enabled and I put Arial like this, she's on the curve of the dress, but it will place the motif as if it's 2D, essentially. So what will happen on the side of the dress, like with the pattern, is that it's gonna smudge and stretch and do weird things. Which is not nice. Enabling the wrap, which is I call wrap, allows you to just nicely place it around. Even if I place it all the way like here, it will still be absolutely fine all the way over there. So that's it for the base, very base of the design tool and all its options. All right, on to the third part, which will be the tips and tricks or the frequently asked questions that I've gotten while posting in the Facebook groups with my designs. One of these questions, the first question that I've been asked a lot, is like, on dresses like this, like, how do you get that sharp cut of color? How do you get your dress in multiple colors? Or this one. Now, the answer to that is very, very simple. The base color, let's say in this instance, we're going to make it white. We're going to take shapes, in this case, squares. We're going to make the square black. In advanced options, I'm going to turn on this globe feature, which wraps the feature and allows me to upsize it all the way to this. Now, unfortunately, all the way upsized, it still doesn't nicely fit all around the dress, which is unfortunate, but it's fine. We're just going to have to use multiple layers. So what I do is I place it here. I'm going to slightly turn it so it can follow the line on the bodice. Look, I want it to be slightly more, slightly outwards, slightly more still. You're never going to follow the line perfectly with a square, but you know, if you can get it somewhere along that line, it is good enough. So I like where this is now. I'm going to turn on the advanced feature and I'm going to turn on the duplicate. Now you can see, like I mentioned before, that with this option, I can move both squares at the same time right now. I'm not gonna, because I'm happy where I placed the first one. But you can see that the mirrored one is, well, not mirrored. It's completely off in its shape from how the original one is. But as I mentioned before, once you actually place it, it will actually put it in its rightful position and mirror it across beautifully. So this is how I do the sharp stark of color difference. Oh, actually, let's duplicate another one. Because that way I can just... It's light lays on top of the other layer, but I can move and use this one just again. You can see that there is a slight seam of white along these squares. That's because the base color of the dress is white. It's virtually invisible once you've finished and you're just walking around with it, but I'm a perfectionist and I see this stuff and sometimes it just outright annoys me. So I place this at the bottom. It's good the way that it is. And I will replicate it to the other side. Now working from, you can see that this replication is not completely correct. So I will adjust it. Now, using it in this fashion, you can see that I have a nice split in the middle of the dress. You can also cover this up, again, with shapes. You can use triangles or just whole squares, again, to make the entire bottom of the dress black. But, you know, be creative, use different kinds of shapes, different kinds of things, and, well, you know, do what your heart desires. But that's how it's the color difference is done, because yes, you can only choose one base color. Now, the other question I get asked a lot is about the gradient changes that I have on dresses. For instance, again, on this Queen of Hearts one, you can see this gradient black in the back. And I have it on a number... No, this is just a whole lot of gradients, to be fair. It has a purple gradient, it has a black gradient from the sides, and this is about 5 different gradients layered together. So we're going to be going back to this dress. We're going to be going into shapes. Scroll all the way down where you can see these two squares. There is a short gradient and a large gradient square. So we're going to take the large gradient one. We're going to make it red, for instance. We're going to go into advanced features, turn on the globe or wrapping feature, as I like to call it, and size it all the way up. Now, the same as with the squares, unfortunately, it is not enough to cover the entire dress, as you can see. So again, you're going to have to be using multiple layers. Now, aligning these gradients is sometimes really difficult. I can imagine it's more difficult on a console, but even with the mouse, it sometimes just ticks a little over or a little off. So sometimes you're going to have to be dealing with a slight overlap or a slight gap, depending on which one you find less offensive. Because again, perfectionist, and I hate that kind of stuff. So I like putting the gradient square at the front, because when showcasing your dress, you're mostly going to look at the straight front. So put the first square as best as I can centered in the middle. I don't like making the new exact same square, so I just duplicate it. You can see when placing another one, by the way, that the gradient gets slightly different. Gets slightly more, so like with the up dress, feel free to mess around with that, or you know, add different layers or colors and whatever to get slightly different effects. All up to you. And I take this one over here and I try again. You need to have it at the right height as well if you're not placing it all the way at the bottom. If you say like, I don't want the bright red but I want this, then make sure that when aligning them you have approximately the same color. This one is aligned to the bottom though, so again, like what I said, there's this tiny little seam here, which is just something we're gonna have to live with, or you know, a slight overlap like that. You can see the red line going up, so I don't know which one's more offensive right now, but I'm gonna go with this. Since I'm happy with its placement, I will go advanced and duplicate, which will duplicate it to the other side. Now, because the center wasn't actually centered, there's a bigger gap here, so we're just gonna take this duplicated square and do the same thing I did with the same problem. So there you go. A white dress with a red gradient. Now, when using these gradients, you can also just do the absolute reverse. So you can flip it. You can both make a gradient from the bottom and from the top. If you're gonna make a belt per se, you can cover this sharp line up, and then you have red coming from the top and from the bottom. What you can also do, make it a little bit smaller just to showcase this, is do this, duplicate this, and then flip this one and the controls are a little over it, which is unfortunate. Same problem, align it here. Now here you get a gradient that moves actually from the center outwards, and there's no sharp lines because you've aligned the both of them together. So you know, feel free to mess around with it. Use some on the. I often use one at the bottom. You often use one all the way at the, either at the belt or all the way at the top. You can make the red straight from the line, or like I said, you can push it all the way up and have this really subtle color. But that's completely up to you. Yeah, other than, you know, making motifs yourself out of different shapes, there isn't much more to the tips and tricks, I'd say. So I'm gonna move on to actually trying to replicate this dress for you all. Hopefully in a very clear fashion, so you can follow along, make your own, or make your own version if you want. Just to give you an idea of, you know, when even something like this, which has been very popular among the people, you can accomplish fairly easy. So that'll be in the next part. And we're at the next part. So we're gonna go back to that last dress that I have. And now, you think that for the Lion King dress, we're going to be taking one of these yellow, orange, or red colors because the dress is mainly composed of these colors. But we're not. It's a silhouette dress, and for one of those extra tricks that I mentioned earlier, I can showcase here. So we're going to go with a base color of black. Now, we're going to start at the beginning. We're first going to set the colors of the dress. The bodice of the dress was red. I'm going to choose a bit. I don't remember what I had. I think this red. Can always change it later. Turn on the wrapping feature, upsize it all the way, and place it here. Now, even on its biggest setting, if you round it like, let's say, here, center it to the best of my ability, it will not wrap all the way around. Actually, that's generally when I design, I pick a shorter hairstyle, so you can actually see the back. So I generally just do this, and then I place one in the back. But you can also make it just align to the seam, which is essentially maybe smarter, and replicate it. Get a little square in the back, that's okay. You can overlap it later if you want. That's a little bit on the high end for me now, so I'm actually going to delete that one and place it a bit further down. Actually check it this time. Okay, and replicate it to the other side. There we go. I think I actually had a darker red. For the bodice. We're gonna take, well, let's say a base color of orange. Same thing. Upsize it all the way. Which I'm going to be placing here to color the rest of the dress. Actually, slightly turn this. Slightly turn it less. Bit more. That's decent. And a little bit further in so that the entire square at the bottom here matches the seam. Yeah, that's fine. And I'm going to duplicate it to the other side. Duplicate it again so we get an exact replica here, and I'm going to pull it. That essentially doesn't really matter if this is aligned or not, because it's just going to be one color of orange, but, you know, perfectionist, so there you go. It's not smart, it needs to align the seam. So now it's not aligned. There we go. And now we just need to cover the center. So again, going to take a base square, duplicate it. The duplication is always going to be at the top of the list. And just place it nicely here in the front. Duplicate it again and cover the bottom. Try to put the seam as nicely as I can so it's not bothersome. There we go. Now we have a red and orange dress, despite that the base color of the dress is black. Let's see. Let's put the flourish on the bodice. That was black. Again, wrap it and put it all the way up. Turn the advanced options off so I can see better. And, well, place it to the best of your abilities. Again, it's not gonna make it all the way around. I have it centered actually quite okay. I prefer not having a weird seam here on the side or the center, so I don't mind this. You can always cover it up a little bit in the back. Again, if you globe this, it will align it to the center, to the seam. So you could, if you don't mind the extra layer. It looks a bit messy though, like this. So I tend to not really bother when it comes to this particular flourish. That is the top part of the dress. Now, the bottom part of the dress is going to be black, because it's basically the land. So again, advanced options, globe to make it larger, and we're going to be dragging it all the way to the bottom of the dress. Now, let's say we want that this is the max I can go down. This is like this, let's say. Duplicate. It's going to be right on top, because I centered it pretty well. And then we're going to just align it over here. Now you can see that it rounds off and it becomes much lower here. You can adjust that if you want. You don't need to, but that's completely up to you. Just make sure that it aligns nicely to this part. Once you're happy with it, advanced options and duplicate to the other side. Again, you could see that it wasn't mirrored initially when you could move it together, but once placed, it's correct. Now, in my other dress, I had this sunset thing going on, so let's create that next. For the sun, we will be taking a half square. I had two layers to it. I had an orange layer, which was just slightly off from the base color of the dress. So you can take this one, or we can take this one. Upsize it, wrap it. And let's see, how big do we want it? The bigger one. So the biggest one is this, but that's far too big. So let's say this. Now, it's slightly not aligning. To offset this problem, you can essentially just drag it below squares. That way it will fall behind it and you won't see if it's not properly aligned. Now we want the sun also in a lighter color, so I'm going to duplicate it again. Now you can undo the mirror of it, but you can also duplicate it again. That way this third one is the exact replica of the first one, I'm sorry. And I'm going to delete this one. So this one is lying now on top of the other orange one and is exactly the same. We want this one to be a beautiful golden color. Let's say this one. And we're just gonna downsize it and then place it down here. I would have absolutely loved a gradient circle, because that's what I wanted to do. When I made that dress, I'd been messing around with the gradient squares and creating these outward lines, but they slightly overlap or they had gaps in between them, and I could never get the beautiful round gradient effect. So unfortunately, that is what we have. Now we're gonna take the characters. Now these are the motifs. I have all motifs, minus the ones from the Deluxe and the Ultimate Edition. Because unfortunately, despite that I love them, it is just, for us, a lot of money. So I'm sad, but unfortunately I'll live without. We're going to be taking this Lion King silhouette one, which is just Simba in his three stages of life. Now we can take this, but I think we're going to want it a bit bigger. So again, we're going to take the global wrapping feature and basically align him to stand in front of the sun. Now you can see that the base motif is colorable, but it has these different shades, which it will constantly do despite whatever I pick. Despite black. But just to showcase what I wanted to showcase, is if you go into the advanced options and you press this cutout, it will be the perfect black to the base of the dress. Which is something we're also going to do, because you can see actually that it's blacker than the black option. So we're going to do the same to the land right now. Select these, make it black, select this, and also make it a cutout. cutouts. So it's all that really hard black from the background. Place it the way you want it, and there we go. The very first of our silhouettes. Now this largely comes into play when making, let's take this Wally 3. This is not colorable. This is just the way that it is. Except for this one trick, which is the cutout. So you get a perfect silhouette in the base color of your dress of the motif that you just cut it out from. So we're gonna be dragging this under and make a little beautiful little tree effect. I want another one, so I'm gonna duplicate it to the other side. Let's make this one a bit bigger, because we can. Well, there we go, the first of our silhouettes. You can also, there is a, maybe this even works, I haven't tried. Yeah, it still looks like a mushroom, but you could make it function as a tree, I guess. You could potentially put this on top and give it a bit more of a tree effect. I know, creative process. That's kind of how it functions. Try. The other, like, actual tree is this one, which you can cut out, and then you have another tree that you can place somewhere. Wrapping feature, you can make it bigger. Let's say I'm gonna place, actually I'm gonna place this one here, and then I'm gonna move this one a bit further back, like this. Yeah, like this. There, I had a, if I remember correct, let's actually check. Yeah, I had a star effect here. We shall show you how to replicate that. There's another tree, another Wally tree in the back. That's the one we were making. I had a little extra leaf effect cut out. Not gonna wrap this one because I want it really small. Let's have this falling leaf idea from the trees. Let's duplicate this one. Slightly change its size. There. Beautiful. Let's place another one of these on the back of the dress. I would love to have more Lion King motifs. I'd like, love to have Simba, Pumbaa, Timon, actual Scar. Maybe we'll get him with the next update next week. But for now, we're working with what we have. No, there's that. There is the sun, which I had placed like this. And I had made it orange on the other dress. And I duplicated it. And I'm going to duplicate it again to get the exact same one back. I'm going to delete this one. Now, two exact layers on top of each other. I'm gonna make one black by cutout. And we're gonna slightly downsize this. So you get that little bit of light effect behind it, I guess. That's already most of it, to be honest. Now we're just for the extra effects. We're gonna go here into shapes, all the way at the bottom, these gradient effects. And, well, we want this light to come up from the bottom, right? So that's wrap to make it bigger. And we're going to be dragging this layer all the way beneath all the stuff that we've done, minus the colors, because we wanted to overlap the colors, otherwise we won't see it. And we want it behind the sun. Yes. So you just take a look at what you like. I mean, you can make it really light, you can make it a bit brighter yellow like that. You can make it, you can also say, like, I want a red glow. There, make a red glow. But we're gonna, since we're replicating the other one, we're gonna go with a lighter yellow, let's say this one. And again, depending on how, you can drag it all the way to the edge of the black here to not see this sharp yellow line, because it'll be hidden behind the black line. You can make it more yellow, or if you drag it further down, you can make it less yellow. You can just play with the gradients, really. I'm gonna put it like this, I think. Now you can see this line here, because again, it doesn't go all the way around, so we'll duplicate this. This is the fun part where you're constantly scrolling up and down, which is even more fun when you're on 50 layers, or nearing 50 layers. And I'm gonna be putting this one in. Now here's where you have to watch if, depending on the height that you put it, that you have it at the same. And that the seams are aligned. Duplicate it to the other sides. Put that layer down again. Further down behind the black and behind the sun squares. And check if it's, see this one's not aligned, it's overlapping way too far. No. Attempt to slightly turn it to make the seam less visible. But there you go, now there's a gradient here. And we could essentially add another gradient to that. Size it all the way. Drag this all the way down to where my gradients are. This will give it a bit of a darker reddish effect. I love that. So we have the yellow all the way down. We're gonna put that there. Now you can, don't see the difference a lot like that, but when you look here, you can actually see that it is a little bit darker, namely up there. And again, you can play with this to see, you know, look how it changes, depending on the things that you choose. So, you know, just play around with what you like. Duplicate it again. Hope you don't hear my mouse scrolling too much. Align this to that layer, which is here behind the black. Down, not good. Yeah, good. Okay. And copy to the other side. Again, grab layer. And check if it's aligned here, which no, it isn't, because I didn't center it good enough. Now I can't drag this any further because I'm on the seam, unfortunately. So I'm gonna have to take the center one and move it slightly left so it's actually centered. And then align these two again. And this one. There you go. That's essentially that dress. I don't like how orange the second layer. I'm actually gonna make it this orange now, because with the yellow gradient behind it, it was actually way too strong. Yeah, that was, this is pretty much it, how you make it. You can, again, you can make a gradient come from the top as well. You can add other silhouettes if you want. I mean, be creative, play around with the motifs, see what you can make. I had this idea of making Zazu out of taking the crow that you get, the only bird that you get, cutting it out for the silhouette. I want him facing that way, so I'm going to mirror him. It's going to have to be a bit bigger, unfortunately. And then take the banana beak, cut it out so it's also black, and downsize it as much as you can, which is why, unfortunately, it needs to be this big. Because then we can create an actual banana beak. It's a shame that this is the smallest you can make, because this is what I meant with really small, detailed work. Due to the fact that this is the smallest I can make this, that means that the bird actually has to be bigger, or the proportions are horrendously off. But you know, I am personally not the greatest fan of how the shape turned out, but you know, something you can use. So that's that. That's a basic silhouette dress, the Lion King one that a lot of people loved. So it's not too difficult. I hope you can replicate it yourself. Show me your results if you want. And if you have more questions or want to know more things, feel free to give me a nudge on the Facebook posts or here on YouTube. And I'll do my best to answer everybody. And well, thank you for watching. Gonna run a small showcase of all the dresses that I have so far, and maybe I'll make another one day. But for now, I hope this has helped you, so enjoy your day and your evening furthermore.